Welcome to Yoga Calm. My name is Brenda. I'm going to title this one Peace. So hopefully this will bring you a little peace in your day or maybe throughout your week. So let's go ahead and find our way onto our backs. We'll do a few extra restorative poses today. So let's go ahead and find our way onto our backs. Feet either hip distance apart or extended long on our mat. The legs are extended, just let the ankles fall open. Arms come away from our side, palms face up, about a 45 degree angle away from our body. And then I always like to kind of wiggle into it, like you're finding that perfect spot, either in your bed or your couch, or maybe a warm sandy beach, or maybe a meadow. And then just let all distractions go as we try to think about what we're doing, being present, trying not to think about what's next in our practice or what we want to do after practice. So as we settle in, allow the mat and the floor to hold you up so that you can let go a little more. So as we lay here, we relax the abdomen, which allows us to better belly breathe. Trying to make full use of the lungs, including the lower lobes, as we inhale through the nose. Let the stomach rise like a sleeping baby. Let the ribs expand as we fill the lungs completely with air. And then gently exhale when you're ready. Feel the ribs gliding down and in towards the pelvis, gently blowing all the air out. Staying here for a few more rounds of slow belly breathing, please. Taking one more slow breath here. And stepping our feet in one at a time. Circle the knees around into our chest. Let's place one hand on each knee and let the legs relax. So let the hands hold the legs up. Pretend like we have magic markers on our knees and let's just make little circles on the ceiling. Hands creating the circular motion. Working on mobility of our sacroiliac joints, getting blood flow towards that area and mobility. And then let's go the other way. Again, little circles. Let the hands create the circles with the knees. Let's do one more. And then rock through the tailbone area. Again, letting the hands create the rocking motion. Let's do one more. And now go side to side across the low back. Massage it on your mat. And then release the rock, letting the feet return to the mat one at a time. Preparing for bridge rolls. Arms are by our side, palms down. Inhale, neutral spine, exhale, pelvic tilt, and then peel the spine away from our mat, one vertebra at a time, rolling up, inhale at the top, and then exhale, roll down, like you're melting back to the mat. Nice and slow, tailbone touches last, return to a neutral spine, inhale, and exhale, pelvic tilt, tip, peel, and curl, roll up, Inhale at the top, exhale, roll down. Tailbone touches last. Return to a neutral spine once more. Please inhale. Exhale, pelvic tilt. Try not to rush our movements. Inhale at the top and exhale, roll down. Hollow out the low belly. Tailbone touches last and return to a neutral spine. Good job. Let's go ahead and hug our left knee into our chest. Chin's lightly tucked. The back of the neck is long. And then release the tension a little bit. Extend the right leg long, flex the foot, toes to the ceiling. Hug the left knee back in gently. Release the tension slightly. Bring your right foot back in. Now roll through the head, neck, and shoulders. Try to bring your nose to your knee. Release, roll back down. Cross the left ankle above the right knee like you're making a triangle with your legs. Bring the right foot up off the floor. If you want, roll up and grab behind the thigh, head up or down. So reclining half pigeon. We're stretching out our left hip and glute here. And then release. Right foot to the floor, uncross the ankle. And now let's hug the right knee in. Chin lightly tucked again, back of the neck is long. Release the tension slightly, extend the left leg long, flex the foot, toes to the ceiling, and then hug the right knee in a little bit more. Release the tension slightly, step the left foot back in, roll through the head, neck, and shoulder, try to bring the nose towards the knee. And then release, roll back down, cross the ankle above the knee. Left foot up off the floor, roll up, grab behind the thigh, head up or down. Reclining half pigeon, stepping up, stretching out our right hip here. And then release, left foot to the floor, uncross the ankles. Nice job. Circle the knees around into the chest. Open up the knees, happy baby. Roll through the head, neck, and shoulder. Grab the arches of the feet or the big toes. Let the knees fall outside our ribs. The soles of the feet over time facing the ceiling like we're trying to walk on it. Gravity-assisted stretch. Happy baby. Full spider. Good. Releasing the feet one at a time. Finding your block if you have one. Pick up the hips, put the block at the low part of your back, right above the glutes. And then we're going to bring one leg up, followed by the other. We can stay here, so an inversion with support, or we can extend the legs long. So legs up a wall, the imaginary wall. Again, with or without the block. Let's just go ahead and close the eyes for a few rounds of breath. If your legs start to get tired, remember you can bend the knees or return the feet to your mat. And now bend the knees, staying here for a few rounds of breath. Get a little restorative inversion. And then return the feet to your mat one at a time. We're going to continue to use the block. We're going to go ahead and lift the hips up. And we're going to put the block. Remember, we have tall, we have medium, and we have a short side. I'm going to have you put it on the medium side, top part of your glutes. It's going to support you. You can hold on to the block as long as you'd like. Or if you feel comfortable, feel free to let it go. This is a hip opener. If you'd like a little more intensity and your body allows, put the block at the top height, again, right above your glutes. You can hold on to it the whole time or just till you feel comfortable and then arms come away from your side. Again, a hip opener. Continue to belly breathe. One more breath here. When you're ready, go ahead and find your block, pick up your hips, set your block off to the side, and lower your hips down. Circle the knees around into the chest. One hand on each knee, and let's rock side to side once more across our low back. The lumbar spine, giving it a little massage. Release the rock, and then we're gonna go ahead and come up to seated. You can roll to your right or rock and roll. Try to come up on your third rock. Finding our way into easy seated pose on the front edge of our block. If you don't have a block, you can also use a firm pillow, a bolster. We're going to place one heel in front of the other. We'll cross the ankles. It's always an option if that makes your knees and hips happier. Legs out, one or two in front. And we're going to start with our chest and back opener. Hands come to heart center. Draw the forearms together, lift up through the middle. Inhale, reach for our sides. And then exhale. Hands and forearms come back together. Inhale, open the chest. Exhale, close it. Again, eyes open or closed. Let's do once more in this direction. Good job. Reverse it. Come down through the center. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. Last time. Nice job. Let's go ahead and take our hands up into our peace signs, giving ourselves a little peace, love, and understanding. Going into seated twist to the right. Right hand close to the glute. Left hand on the outside of our thigh. Inhale, thighs level. Exhale, rotate from the bottom up. Easy seated twist. Don't force it. Drop the shoulders and belly breathe a little bigger, please. Inhale and exhale, derotate, come back center, changing sides. Left hand close to the glute, right hand on the outside of her thigh. Inhale, get taller. Exhale, gently rotate. Belly breathing again. Inhale and exhale, derotate, come back center. Opposite foot goes in front, now we're on top. Getting our peace out again. When you're ready, drop the right hand close to the glute, left hand on the outside of our thigh. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, rotate. Inhale and exhale, derotate, come back center. Changing sides once more, please. Inhale, get taller. Exhale, rotate when you're ready. Inhale and exhale, derotate, come back center. Nice job. Let's bring the soles of our feet together for our cobbler's pose. Grabbing the ankles or the toes and then butterfly the legs. I'm releasing our flutter. Inhale, sit tall. Exhale, hinge forward from the hips. Think about coming forward with a flat back, head in line with the spine. Collarbones are wide, shoulders are down, so try not to hunch. Think length. Inhale and exhale, rise up. Good job. Butterfly once more. And then release the flutter. Inhale, sit taller. Exhale, hinge forward from the hips. Shoulders down again. Facial features are soft, including the mouth, the eyes. If you wish, apply gentle pressure to the inside of the legs. Inhale and exhale, rise up. Great job. Let's go ahead and come off our block. Just place it behind us. And we're going to extend the left leg long out in front. We're going to cross the right leg over the left. And we're going to hug the knee into the chest. So flex your left foot like you're bringing the toes to the ceiling. Try to have the shoulders and hips in the same plane like you're up against a wall. And then lift the right arm up to the ceiling. Drop it close to the right hip. Flat palm or fist for wrist. Push the floor away as we get taller. Hug the knee in a little more and then rotate to your right. Good. Inhale and exhale, derotate. If you wish, bend your left knee. Bring your heel underneath you. Continue to hug the knee into the chest and go ahead and lean into it. So again, left leg underneath or out long in front. Another nice hip stretch on the right side. Inhale and exhale to rise. Uncross the legs. Right leg long in front. Left leg over the right. Hug the knee into the chest. Toes up towards the ceiling. Shoulders and hips in the same plane if we can. And now reach the left arm to the ceiling. Drop it close to the glute. Again, flat palmed or fist for wrist. Push the floor away, get taller. Hug the knee in and rotate to your left. A gentle twist. Inhale and exhale, derotate. Come back center. Right leg can stay long or come underneath us. Hug the left knee into the chest and then lean into it. So again, right leg underneath or out in front. Relax the shoulders. Inhale and exhale to rise. Great job. Uncross the legs. Let's come to hands and knees as we prepare for cat-cow. So knees underneath our hips, wrists underneath our shoulders. Flat palm or fist for wrists again. Inhale, neutral. Exhale, cat. Drop the tailbone down. Hollow out the low belly. Slowly round up. Arching our back. Spreading our shoulder blades. Let the head hang last. Inhale, cow. Tailbone tilts up. Sitting bones open. Round the spine down towards the mat. Draw the shoulders down and in. Head comes up last. And then flow back and forth. Cat-cow. Eyes open or closed. Trying to move slow. Let's do one more round, cat-cow. Returning to our neutral spine. Draw the big toes together. Push back into extended child. Trying to get our hips to rest on our heels over time. You can always put the block between the hips and the heels for a little support if that makes your knees happier. Or underneath the forehead. Let's draw the hands underneath the shoulders. Try to keep the hips and the heels connected. Lightly tuck the chin and let's roll ourselves up, stack at our spine, one vertebra at a time. Great job. Let's walk out into a plank pose. So our plank can always be on hands and knees or hands and toes or some of each. Inhale, plank. Exhale, down dog. So tailbone to the ceiling as we press our chest to our thighs. Remember, we can move our hands or our feet, it's okay. We're attempting to put our body into an upside down V position and then put the weight a little heavier in our feet. Our ears are next to our upper arms. Our gaze is to the tip of our nose. Inhale up on the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Press the front of the thighs to the back of them just a little stronger. Inhale. Inhale up on the toes. Exhale, come forward into your plank. Again, knees or toes, upper back flat. Lower the body as one unit. Top of the feet flat, elbows hug the ribs. Inhale and exhale, half cobra. Reaching the crown of our head for the wall in front of us. We want to keep our feet anchored down. We want to keep our hands light. Relax the shoulders and let's belly breathe. We try to rise and fall with the breath. If you find it challenging to rise and fall with your breath, the belly breath, lower yourself just a little bit and try it again. Inhale, half cobra, and exhale, return to the mat. Nice job. Dig the feet in again, hip distance apart, please. Inhale, and exhale, down dog. So hips go up and then back. Big hands, engage all the knuckles. Let's walk our dog. So you can pedal the feet if you wish. Encourage you to do it slow, enjoying the extra stretch of this straight leg. One more. Inhale up on all the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Inhale up on the toes. Exhale, come forward into your plank, knees or toes. Lower the body as one unit. Top of the feet flat, elbows hug the ribs. Inhale and exhale, half cobra. Relax the shoulders and belly breathe again. Big and slow. Inhale and exhale to lower. Pushing back into extended child. Big toes together, knees together or apart. Again, with or without our block. Relax the shoulders when you're ready and take your breath into the back of the lungs. And draw the hands underneath the shoulders. Lightly tuck the chin in. Let's roll ourselves back up, stacking our spine. Coming into seated diamond. Good job. Preparing to rise. Let's bring the right leg forward, hand right in the middle of the muscle, and just come on up to standing. Come into the center of our mat, and we'll line up in our mountain. So outside edges of our feet parallel with each other. Pick up all the toes. Give yourself a little peace again. And then set the toes back down. Rotate the inner thighs to the outside. Shoulders up, back, and down. Relax at the sternum again. And then close the eyes. You may sway. As your body adjusts to your straighter plumb line. And then open the eyes. Great job. Let's go ahead and bend the knees, step or jump wide, preparing for triangle. We're going to turn our right foot out 90 degrees, the left foot in 20 degrees. And it's always important that the heel, the front foot is in line with the arch of the back foot and that the pelvis is level. So try not to dip the front hip is what I say. Slide the ribs out to your right, push the left hip out to your left, and then open up. So if you want to think about the triangle, I like to point this out every once in a while, is your legs are making a triangle, and then your right arm, right leg, and right torso, side of your torso, is making a triangle. So Trikonasana, triangle. If you choose, gaze up towards the extended hand. Don't forget to breathe. Good. Bring the gaze front, inhale, and exhale, drive through the back foot to come up. Arms up or down as we change sides. So left foot out, right foot in, square it up, hug it up with those thigh bones. Slide it out to your left. Cartwheel over, again, making your triangles with your legs your left arm, your left side body. If you choose, gaze up towards the extended hand. Good, bring the gaze back front, inhale, and exhale, drive to the back foot to come up. Arms coming down this time, let's change sides again. So right foot out, left foot in, level off the pelvis, float the arms up, slide the ribs out, cartwheel over. Good, relax the shoulders, long neck again. Make sure that right thigh is firm, supporting the knee and the hip joints. And now reach the top arm for the sidewall if you choose. Or ragdoll, let it hang. And then extend it once more. Good, inhale. And exhale, drive through the back foot to come up. Changing sides. Left foot out, right foot in, hug it up, level it. Slide it out, cartwheel over. Good. Shoulders and hips in the same plane. If you choose, top arm reaches for the side wall, making sure our left thigh is firm. Add our ragdoll if you wish. Nice job. Top arm extends. Inhale and exhale, drive through the back foot to come up. Arms come down. We're going to turn both feet out on both legs. And then we're going to go ahead and bend the knees, hands to our thighs to start. And we're going to walk ourselves out to a side lunge. So getting our inner thigh, we can be high or low. I just want your head above your heart and above your bottom. And then we're going to walk through the center over to the left. So toes turned out. Again, getting our adductors, our inner thighs. Good, let's walk back to the right. Again, high or low. And now we're going to go ahead and pivot to our right. Good. So our left knee can be up or down. Our hands can frame the foot or be on the muscle. So avoid the knee again. Good. Now, lower your right knee to the mat, top of the foot flat, inhale, and exhale, crescent, lift and open. Excuse me, that was your left knee. Good. Go ahead and sweep forward, frame the foot, dig the back toes under, pop the knee off, walk through the center. So you're pivoting again, now you're coming back over to the other side. Getting again our inner thighs, our adductors. Pivot all the way over to face the opposite wall. Back knee down or up. So a runner's lunge here. And now lower the back knee to the mat. Inhale and exhale, crescent, lift and open. Keep breathing slow and steady. Inhale and exhale, hands sweep forward. Bring the back knee off your mat. Return to the front, so pivot back around. Going to come right in the middle. We're going to bend both knees. Toes are still turned out. Head, again, ideally is above the heart and above your bottom. Let's bring our hands to our thighs. Avoid the knees and lift the torso up. Straighten the legs. Step or jump the feet together. Great job. We're going to go into tree. So on your mat or off your mat, remember you can always be close to wall if you'd like. So gently brace. So push the hands together lightly and find something to focus on, something to stare at. And then get your kickstand out on the right side. So big toe is your kickstand. Good. Stay low with the trunk or grow it. Pick it up or slide it up. Heel above or below the knee, not right on it. We're going to push the foot into the leg and the leg into the foot. And then think about pushing the floor away, getting a little taller with our leg, our torso. Staying low with the arms or grow the branches. You can get creative. You can be asymmetrical. Get your peace signs out again. Nice job. Hands return to heart center and release the right leg. Gently brace, find your focus again, your gazing point. Kickstand out on the left. Stay low or grow your trunk. Again, heel above or below the knee, not right on it. Push the foot into the leg into the foot. Push the floor away, get taller. Grow your branches. Peace signs out. Lift the heart. Good, hands return to heart center and release the left leg. Great job. From here, side angle. Bend the knees, step or jump wide. So it's a little wider than our triangle if our body allows. Right foot out 90 degrees, left foot in 20. Level off the pelvis for me. Float the arms up. Good. Bending our front knee up to 90 degrees, trying to get the knee above the ankle and the thigh parallel with the ground over time. Takes a while to get there. Hand or forearm on the muscle and then grow your top arm. Peace sign out again. Hold hands. Good. Think about lifting the arch of your left foot. Inhale and exhale, reverse your warrior. Level off the pelvis. Good. Inhale and exhale, return to side angle. Again, give me your hand or your forearm on your thigh. Trying to get the right knee again to 90 degrees directly above the ankle. Again, over time, be patient with yourself. Inhale and exhale, rise. Good job. Arms coming down. Let's change sides. So now left foot out, right foot in. Level off the pelvis, hug the thigh bones. Arms up, shoulders down. Bend the left knee up to 90. And then hand or forearm to your thigh. Left arm position of choice, peace sign out, one or both hands. Keep breathing slow and steady. Good, inhale, exhale, reverse our warrior. Gaze to the side wall or up towards the extended hand. Inhale and exhale, side angle. Again, peace signs with the hands, with the fingers. Great job. Inhale and exhale, drive to the back foot to come up. Both feet point straight ahead. Bend the knees, step or jump the feet back together. Great job. We're going to go ahead and go into chair from here. So feet can be together, a little more support. Feet separated about hip distance apart. Gently brace at heart center, inhale, and exhale, sit back into your chair. So I always like to say, make sure you have a neutral spine. So if you feel pain or pressure in your low back, you might be overarching it. Drop your tailbone down, snug up the low belly. Arms out, peace signs out. Relax, draw the ribs down. So it's real easy to want to flare with the rib cage. Try not to. Think about them sliding down. Slide and glide. Hands back to heart center. Inhale and exhale. Drive up to standing. So staying hip distance apart or bringing the feet completely together. Gently brace. Inhale and exhale. Sit back into our chair. So if the feet are together, push. Think about pushing the knees together. Again, neutral spine. You feel pressure. Drop the tailbone down. Growing your arms, peace signs out, breathe. Strong legs. Great. Hands come back to heart center, inhale, and exhale, rise up. Nice job. Preparing to lower. Let's go ahead and come to the short edge of our mat. Feet can be parallel or staggered, staggered or parallel, and then rise up and balance on the balls of the feet, and then slide down the wall. Go ahead and bow forward, step, jump, or walk back into your plank. Hands and knees or hands and toes. Inhale and exhale, down dog. So hips up and back again. Drop the ribs towards the hips. Let the arms frame the head like a picture. Good. Inhale up on the toes. Exhale, lower the heels. Press the front of the thighs to the back of them a little stronger. Good. Inhale up on the toes. Exhale, lower the knees to our mat. Top of the feet flat. Big toes together. Extended child. So with or without a block, use the arms overhead to push back a little more if you wish. Now draw the hands underneath the shoulders. Lightly tuck the chin in. Let's roll ourselves back up, stacking our spine. Returning to seated diamond. Wonderful. Let's find our way onto our back. Getting our stretch strap out. Remember, if you don't have one, you can use a towel, or you can even take an old towel and cut a strip and make it your strap. So finding our way onto our backs any way we want. We're going to take the strap and place it around the ball of the right foot. And then we're going to put the strap in the right hand, and I just want you to circle your leg. Doesn't matter which direction, because we're going to go both ways. And now go the other way. So let your hand create the circular motion with the leg. And then bring the leg center, one end of the strap in each hand. Toes to the nose, heel towards the ceiling, a gentle stretch in the back of our right leg. And then release the tension slightly. Good job. Put the tension back on. Now let's walk up our strap. So bending the knee as much as we need to grab both sides of the foot. So if you can keep your leg straight, I can't, you go for it. Just grab both sides of the foot, flatten the foot out, try not to let it roll in or out. Return your hands to the strap, lower your upper body down, and straighten the right leg again if you had to bend it. Good, release the tension, and now we're going to let the leg go down and up, using the strap to lower and lift the leg. So an active hamstring stretch. Once more, bring it back center and hold. This is the static part, the static stretch. The other one was dynamic. And then release the tension. Go ahead and release the strap. Slowly lower the right leg back to the mat. And then once it gets to the mat, let it relax, wiggle it out from hip to toes. Stepping our right leg in. And then strap goes around the ball of the left, so avoid the arch, please. Hands high or low as we start with that static stretch. Toes to the nose, heel to the ceiling. Remember, it should be a gentle stretch, nothing painful. And then release the tension. And now both ends of the strap in the left hand, we'll do that circle. I almost forgot it on this side, sorry about that. Just reversing the order, changing it on you. And now go the other way. Let your hand, let the strap create the circular motion. It can be big or small. Let's do one more circle. Put the stretch back on, chin lightly tucked again. Go ahead and walk up your strap. Bend the knee a little or a lot, however you can, to get a hold of your foot. So with both hands, your leg can be straight. Again, like I said, go for it. But it should not hurt. The leg shouldn't quiver or quake. good. Return the hands to the strap, extend the leg up. And now we'll do, again, the straight-legged active stretch. Once more, put the stretch back on and hold. Again, back to our static stretch. Great job. Go ahead and release the tension. Put the strap off to the side. Slowly lower the left leg back to our mat. Once it gets there, let it relax and then wiggle it out. And then we're going to go into our final relaxation pose. I invite you, if you have a block, to get it out. And we'll go into reclined cobblers. So we'll bring the soles of our feet together and rest our feet on the block. If that's uncomfortable at any point in time, just kick it away and extend your legs long. Arms away from our side. Peace signs out again, please. So palms up. And then you need to wiggle into it again, finding that perfect spot. You might want to slide the block a little further away from the body if that feels better to you. So this is a gravity-assisted hip opener as well. Let's return our thoughts to our slow belly breath, please. Allowing our body to sink more and more into our mat with each breath. I'm taking one more breath here, please. And when you're ready, go ahead and circle the knees around into your chest. Return your feet to the mat one at a time. If your block's there, just gently push it off to the side. Good. Go ahead and take your right arm overhead and then roll onto your right side in a fetal position. Use the top hand and the bottom elbow to push yourself up to seated. Finding your way into easy seated pose. Bring in our hands to heart center and namaste. So again, peace, love, understanding for yourself and everyone. Thank you.